academics are usually accused of having their heads in the clouds, but with sufficient support and funding, their knowledge, skills and expertise can help develop ideas and inventions that can shape our everyday lives. ICAST reporter Robin Powell went along to meet Dr. Edirin Williams, director of Warwick Ventures. He runs a technological transfer program here at the University of Warwick. Robin began by asking him, what exactly does technology transfer mean?
In the University of Warwick, there's about £86 million a year spent on research right across all the departments, doing all sorts of exciting research. This leads to inventions, and some of them are exciting, world-beating inventions that need to get out there to the market. Warwick Ventures' job is to identify those, to protect them through patenting when necessary, and to try and commercialise them.
But in purely financial terms, does it pay?
We do it for the benefit of the academics who want to see their invention out there in the world. If we make money, that's great, and we do sometimes. And occasionally we might get a huge blockbuster that makes tens of millions. Most of the time, we're just very glad if we can contribute towards our costs.
You've been doing this for 6 years. You're not yet profitable. Some people might say, is it worth persevering?
If you identify a new pharmaceutical drug, your cure for cancer, for instance, it may take 7 to 10 years to get to market. So this is a fairly long-term business. But the evidence is that there are also long-term financial benefits, as well as, of course, benefits to the economy, to the reputation of the university, to the anything else you care to name.
So how long does it take for an idea to become profitable?
We've been starting spin-out companies since the year 2000. There are now over 30 of them. One of them is actually quoted on the Australian stock market. That's NeuroSolutions, started by Professor Banswick over in biology. But we think we might get a bigger flotation on the London stock market in 2008 of a company that started in 2000. So it's taken 8 years to get from starting to potential stock market flotation.
There's been a great deal of discussion in recent years about university funding. Do you think there'll be a time when universities will rely on technology transfer for its funding?
Not a large proportion. It could make a useful contribution on the side. But the point is, why does the government invest in research? A lot of their reasoning, if you look at the government papers, is for the long-term benefits for the UK economy. And we feel we're an important cog in the wheel, so to speak, to actually deliver those long-term benefits of research.